Hello students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing chapter 17 and in that row children, till yesterday we have finished question number 32. So today children, we are going to start with question number 33 and here we were doing questions that is based on fraction. Multiplication, division, all the operations we were doing on fraction. So in that row children, we will start with question number 33 today. Rahul gave 3 by 4 of his bank balance to his wife. If his bank balance was rupees 28,000, how much did his wife get? So here the question is, that the person whose bank balance is rupees 28,000. Now here the total sum of money is rupees 28,000. Out of 28,000, he gave to his wife 3 by 4 of his balance. So here the fraction of money Rahul gave to his wife, that is 3 by 4 of rupees 28,000. So let's see how to find out the solution. You have to find the solution that how much money he gave to his wife. Question number 33. So Rahul's balance. What is the balance of Rahul in the bank? That is rupees 28,000. So rupees 28,000 is the balance of money which Rahul is having in the account. Rahul balance, that is rupees 28,000. Now he gave to his wife. What amount of money he gave to his wife? He gave to his wife 3 by 4. Now this fraction of money he gave to his wife. You have to write this fraction of money, fraction of money he gave to his wife, that is 3 by 4. So sum or money given, how will you find it out? That is 3 by 4. Will be multiplied by rupees 28,000. So what we will do next? Now first of all, we are going to reduce it. 4 ones are 4, 4 sevens are 28. Then 7,000 will be multiplied by 3. That is rupees 21,000. So Rahul gave to his wife rupees 21,000. So what was the question? This kind of a question you have done earlier also. Rahul's bank balance is rupees 28,000. The bank balance in the account of Rahul, you can see that is rupees 28,000 here. And fraction of money he gave to his wife, that is 3 by 4. Now this statement you are going to write like this only. Fraction of money he gave to his wife, that is 3 by 4. Now how much money he gave to his wife, that is 3 by 4 of rupees 28,000. Therefore, Rahul gave to his wife rupees 21,000. Or here only you can write. Either you will write this therefore, or you can write here only therefore. And you don't require to write it again. Money given, that is this much. So 3 by 4 of rupees 28,000. 4 ones are 4. 4 sevens are will be 28. Rupees 7,000. 7,000 will be multiplied by 3. So that will become 21. Rupees 21,000. So Rahul gave to his wife rupees 21,000. So this is one of the example of word problem of fraction. So children, that you have already done in the fraction chapter. Now we'll do the next question, that is question number 34 from your book. That is expressed as decimal fractions. Now you have been given with decimal after fraction, the important chapter which we have, that is your decimal. So express as decimal fraction, question number 34 is this. Express as decimal fractions. Okay, so what we have to do it in this decimal fraction, you have been given with 0.3. now how many decimal place this number is having? 1. So we are going to remove this decimal place and that will be divided by 10. So this will become decimal, which is represented in the form of fraction. Now if you have to represent a decimal in the form of fraction, how many decimal places it have, that you have to see. Like this second question, 0.17. So how many decimal places we have to? We'll write here 17, that will be divided by 100. That will be divided by 100, because 100 contains two zeros. Now one more example I will give, 0.345. Three decimal places, so we'll write 3, 4, 5. That will be divided by 1000. That will be divided by 1000. As many decimal places will be there, those many zeros you are going to add. So that is your representation of a decimal into decimal fraction. Or sometimes we call it that how express the decimal as fraction. Express the decimal as fractions. So that you will do it. Now question number 35, write in expanded form. How to write it? Question number 35 is express in decimal form. Express as expanded form. 35 question. Expanded form. So now what we will do here? Expanded form. See, for getting it into expanded form, it is very important to know the place value of a decimal number. Now what are the place value of decimal number? Now, let's say here you have this decimal point. Before that decimal point, that you have the same. Ones, tens, hundred, thousand, the same. But after decimal point, the first place is tens, then second is hundred, then the third one is thousand. 1 by 10, 1 by 100, 1 by 1000. So these are the places. And the same we are going to copy here. Expanded form 3 plus. Now 0.5. Now 0.5 can be written in this form also. 3 plus 5 by 10. See this 10th place. So it will be divided by 10. 100th place. So it will be divided by 100. So now this will become the expanded form of a decimal number. Expanded form of a decimal number. Let's say one more part, B part. That is 12.09. So what we will do? 12 plus. On 12 can be written 10 plus 2. Because 10's place, then 1's place. 10 plus 2. Now here 0 is there on 10's place. So that is not necessary to write it down. So we will write it 0.09. So that will become 10 plus 2 plus 9 by 100. So this will become expanded form of this given number. Fine. Now if you want to write this place, you can write it. But what you will write it? You will write 0 over there only. You have to write 0 over there. That doesn't contain any value. So that is not necessary to write it down. So we will take only that number which has some denomination or that denominator value. So we'll start with question number 36, that choose decimals from the bracket which are equivalent to the given number. Now, in this question, you have to choose the correct numbers from the bracket which has the same value as the number. So here A part is question number 36, A part. Decimal number can be written by adding as many zeros after 5. You can write 3.5 as 3.50, 3.500, 3.50000. That all contains the same value as of 3.5. But if you will put before 5, then that number will be changed. So we will write this now. You have to take the correct option 3.50. Then 5.3, then 3.05. Now when we will put 0 before that 5, that number is totally getting changed. But after 5, we can put as many zeros as you want. So here the correct answer is this. Now these two numbers are equivalent or these two numbers are same. So we will do that B part. Now we will come to B part. B part is what? 9.02. 9.02. You have to choose the correct option, that is 9.20, 9.20, comma 9.12. Now here you are going to understand the concept which I have told you just now. See this. Here what we have done, here you have added 1, 2 zeros after 0.02, right? Fine. So you have added this 0.02, you have added two more numbers, so that will be same as of the given number, because after decimal whichever numbers you are having, after that number you can add as many zeros as you want and the value of that will be same. Now children, will come to the next question, that is your question number 37, add two decimal numbers will be given. How to do the addition? So for doing addition, the very important thing is that addition can be done when a decimal comes just below the decimal. Question number 37, add. Here I am going to take one, two more examples. Only one part is given here, 12.03 and 9.5. Very important thing is how to arrange that number. So for arranging 12.03, decimal will come just below the decimal. 3, then 5. 21.53. So this will become addition. In decimal, remember that rule, that decimal will come just below the decimal. Always. Decimal will come just below the decimal always. That is must follow in each case. And decimal will come just below the decimal in each question. So that you will remember and rest of the things will be same. Addition is same as of addition we were doing. So let's take one more example. That example is not given in your book but will be. Let's say you have this 13.534 and 9.25. So what you will do? 13.534 plus 9.25. Decimal will come. Wherever you do not have any number, there you are going to put a 0. Fine? So 4, 8, 7, 12, 2. So this will become your answer. 22.784. 22.784. So that is your question number 37. Now we will come to question number 38. that is related to your second operations on decimal, that is subtraction. How to subtract the number? So let's come to question number 38. How to subtract? In subtraction also you will remember that rule that decimal will come just below the decimal always. So remember this rule and easily you can do all the questions. Question number 38 now. Subtract 5.91 from 6.8. Subtract 5.91 from 6.8. So what we will do? 6.8 subtract 5.91. Wherever you do not have any number, there you are going to put a zero. Always. In addition, you will see that wherever you do not have any number, there you will put a zero. So now what we will do? This will become 7 and this will become 10. 9, 5, and then this will become 17. 17 minus 9, 8, 0. So this will be your answer, 0.89. So question number 38, then 39, that is your next operation. Let's take one more example of this subtraction. Let's subtract. Let's say you have been given with a whole number. Fine. 44.8 from 50. So if you have to given, you have been given a whole number, so 50 can be written as 50.0 minus 44.8. So that will become 4, 10, 10 will become 9, this will become 10. 10 minus 8, 2, 5, and here 0. So what is the answer here? 5.2 is the answer. So we have seen one more question that is related to 44.8. That is, subtraction. That is related to subtraction. So children, the example which I am telling you, related to like addition, one more question we have done. Subtraction, again one more question we have done. That you don't require to do it. But rest of the question, you will do it. Now question number 39, that is related to next operation, that is multiplication. Question number 39. Multiply 3 point. Multiply 3.92 by 8. Multiply 3.92 by 8. So what we will do now? 3.92 will be multiplied by 8. 8 2's are 16. 8 9's are 72, 73. 8 3's are 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31. And then 2 decimal place, 1, 2 will come, 10 will put a decimal. 31.36. So here what you have to do in multiplication, I'll tell you in a short, that just do the multiplication. After doing multiplication, then just count how many decimal places we have. 2 decimal place will count from back, 1, 2, and will put the decimal place over there. Do the multiplication, do the multiply as we were doing in whole numbers, in that natural numbers. The same way, do the multiplication. After doing multiplication, just count from the back and put the decimal over there. So that is your multiply. That is your multiplication questions. Now we'll come to next, that is divide. That is 0.6 by 2. Division also we'll see. Question number 40. Divide. Now in division, I'm going to take few more questions also, because sometimes in division you will be getting that questions which are not so simple. Divide 0.6 by 2. So this question is quite simple. We'll write as 0.6. So zero, zero will be not, yes, it is coming in two stable, two zeros will be zero. Now, decimal point is there, we will put a decimal, 6 will get a 2 threes will be 6. So, what is the quotient in this case? The quotient is 0.3. The quotient is 0.3. The quotient is 0.3. Let's take one more question. Let's see if you have to multiply this question. 3.53. So how we will do this division? Let's see. 3 ones will be 3, and then we have this decimal point. This decimal point will go into that quotient. Then 8. 3 2s will be 6. 2. Now 1 will be remaining, that will get out. 3 7s will be 21. So what is the quotient here? That is 1.27. Now what do you understand here? That the rest of the division is same, but the only difference is wherever you will get that decimal point will go into the quotient. So remember that wherever you will get the quotient, that decimal point, that will go into the quotient. So now after question number 40, we'll come to question number 41. Express A part 3 by 4 in percentage. Okay, fine. So here you have to express question number 41. Express in percentage, which is your next chapter. Express in percentage. So we'll have this 3 by 4. So this 3 by 4, we were having this 3 by 4. Okay. So what we will do now? We have to require whatever number you are having, which you have to represent in percentage, in that number you required 100 as a denominator. Whenever you will get 100 in the denominator, that number can be written as a percentage. So whichever fraction you are having, you are going to find it out. That fraction will be multiplied by which number, so that you will be getting this 100 in the denominator. So here I have done that. We have multiplied this numerator and denominator by 25. So that will become 75, and 25 folds will be 100. So once you will get 100 in the denominator, that will become the percentage, 75%. So 3 by 4 fraction is exactly what percentage? That is 75%. So now what we will do next? Again, if you have been given any decimal number, so what do we understand in A part? That whatever fraction you are having, let's see if we have this fraction 1 by 5 is how much percent? So what we will do, 5 will be multiplied by 20, here also will multiply by 20. 20 by 100, so that will become 20%. That will become 20%. Let's take one more example. Let's say here you will be having 1 by 4. So that will become 25, and this 4 will become 25. So this will become 25 by 100, which is equal to 25%. We have 3 by 5 again, that will be multiplied by 20. So like this, you can change any fraction into percentage. You can change any fraction into percentage. So we'll come to decimal number now. given with any decimal number. So we will remove the decimal point and put zeros in the denominator. If already we were getting 100 here, so that will become 55%. If we are not getting 100 in the denominator, then we'll make it. Let's say you will have this number. So what we will do? This 5 by 100. So again, this will become 5%. Fine. So whichever question you are having, whichever decimal number you are having, if in a decimal number you were getting 100 in the denominator, then fine, you can write it into percentage. If you are getting this, like, represent this 0.3 into percentage, 0.3. Now here you have only one decimal, only one decimal place. So that will be written 3 by 10. So what we will do, that will be multiplied, the numerator and denominator will multiply by 10. So that will become 30 by 100. Or we can write that will become 30%. That will become 30%. Okay. So this we have seen how to change a decimal number into fraction. Okay. Now 42 question is a word problem. That is, how many half liter bottles can be filled from a can containing 51.5 liters of milk? So what is the quantity of milk in a can? Quantity of milk is 51.5 liters. Question number 42, quantity of milk. Quantity of milk in a can. In a can. That is 51.5 liters. Now this is the quantity of can. But you have to fill a half liter bottle. So number of half liters bottle can be filled. Bottles can be filled is equals to 51.5 liter. That will be divided by half liter. Now half liter is 0.5 liters. Or what you can do, you can change this liters above one, that liter into milliliter, and that will be divided by 500 milliliter. So that also you can do. So let's do with that method only. Now this 51.5 liters, how much milliliter it will become? So that will become 51,000 plus 500. So that will become 51500 milliliter. So that will become 51500 milliliter. That will be divided by 500 milliliter. Because half liter means that is 500 ml only. So that we will do division, 51500. That will be divided by 500. One zero will be 500. 1500. So what we will do here? Here 10 will get out, so we'll put a zero. Then again, then the next will get out. These will be 1500. So here the answer is 103 bottles. Therefore, 103 bottles can be filled. Can be filled. 103 bottles can be filled. So here is your question number 42. So tomorrow we will start with the next word problem of this question number of this chapter 17. So in chapter 17 you will be having only one exercise and mixed problems you are having. So here I hope this question you understand. So we'll meet in the next class. That's all for today. Children, have a good day.